top5rapwebsite.com. You already know what's going on. Number one, where are the new rappers at? You know, usually we have this wave every 6-7 years of new rappers. We saw it in 2010, 2009 with Kendrick, Drake, J. Cole, Wiz Khalifa, Big Sean, Nicki Minaj, etc., etc. We had this huge wave of new artists. And we kind of saw it again like 2015, 2016. We got Uzi Vert. We got 21 Savage, Kodak Black, Yachty. Like, you know, usually we have this wave of new artists, but that's not happened thus far in the 2020s. I guess you could say we have guys like what? Yeet, Destroy Lonely. But this goes to my point. The Yeets, the Destroy Lonelies, these guys are more derivative of what we've already seen. Like Destroy Lonely, like this is Travis Scott plus Lil Uzi Vert. We've heard this already. It's not like refreshing to hear. I've reacted to some Destroy Lonely music on my channel before. Go check it out if you're a Destroy Lonely curious, or if you just want to see my reaction. It's cool. It's not bad music, but it's just more of the same. And Yeet, again, I know people love Yeet, just more of the same. Where are the new artists? And the thing is, when you critique new rappers, or you have any critique, the first thing people want to do is discount you. They want to say, oh, well, you're too old and this and that. Bro, it's not about age. When I was 16, I can go listen to hip-hop and other music that guys way older than me made. Like, I would listen to Ice Cube when I was like 15-16. I listened to Jay-Z, Reasonable Doubt, you know what I mean? I listened to music that was way before my time and appreciated it, as well as appreciate the current music that I had grown up in. And it's not about age, because that when people say that, it almost makes them ageist, as if a young person who's 18, 19, 20, 21 years old can't release a great hip hop album. As if you're of that age group, you're expected to just rap about dumb shit. You're expected to just sound like directly like your influences, like Destroy Lonely sounds like Travis Scott. Like, you're just expected to be not good, not that good, and get a pass. No. When Nas made Illmatic, when that album came out, when it was released, he was what, maybe 18 or 19 years old? And this was in the early 90s. Again, before my time. But this is in the early 90s. He was 18, 19 years old when the album was released. So when he wrote the album, parts of the album he wrote when he was 16, 17, 18 years old. And I can listen to Illmatic today, and songs like Memory Lane, songs like The World Is Yours, bro, those songs are so densely packed, profound. You know, Memory Lane, No Sign of the Beast in the Blue Christ, like, I guess that means peace. For niggas, no shiesty, vice to just snipe you. Like, it's just so lyrically dense and packed in the production. Super producers, Pete Rock, DJ Premier, etc. So I can listen to that today, and I'm listening to like a 16, 17, 18 year old rap, and I don't feel like I'm having to dumb myself down to listen to this. I don't feel like I have to do this thing where I'm like, oh, well, the young people, they don't care about lyrics, so let me just listen to this with a different ear. Like, no, it blends in with every other thing I listen to. It's that good. When Kanye West made My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, that dropped in 2010. He was already Kanye West. He had already released like 3 classic albums. College Dropout, Late Registration, Graduation. He did Blueprint by Jay-Z. But when My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy came out, which was the most anticipated hip-hop album of all time to that point, no other hip-hop album was anticipated like My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. Like, there was a whole, it was a whole, he was already Kanye West. The Kanye West you know and see today, the super prolific, the icon, he was that back then in 2010. In 2009 when the rollout was happening, right? But he was only 6 years into his solo career. I know it's hard to believe, but Kanye West was only 6 years into his solo career when My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy came out. His first album came out in 2004. Dark Fantasy came out in 2010. So you compare that to an artist who's about 6 years into their career today. Let's go with Lil Uzi Vert. Uzi Vert came out like in 2015, 2016. The current year is 2023. That would be like Uzi Vert dropping the most anticipated and the most critically acclaimed album of all time right now. And Uzi Vert just came out with an album called The Pink Tape. And I guess it's good. Like, I listen to Uzi Vert. I didn't listen to that album because I just, you know, the singles didn't do anything for me. I just have no reason to listen to it, right? But that would be like if The Pink Tape was this hugely acclaimed. When Dark Fantasy came out, everyone was watching it. The young folks, the older folks, the people who had just grown up, who had already grown up with Kanye West. It captured the whole hip-hop audience. He was only 6 years into his career. So that would be like Lil Yachty or 21 Savage or Uzi Vert, who's actually further along into their solo career today than Kanye West was back then. Like, the idea of Uzi Vert or 21 Savage or Lil Yachty doing something of that magnitude is almost unthinkable. Like, you probably don't even think of them as artists who are almost 10 years into their career. And that's not to say that, well, I actually do think they're not that good. Uzi Vert, I like his music, you know, especially the Love Is Rage, Eternal Ataki, or A Take, or however you say it, has some songs that I like Sauce It Up. But to think that someone would do something of that, of the magnitude of Dark Fantasy, 6-7 years into their career like Kanye West did, it's unthinkable. I mean, that goes to what I'm saying, that the current music scene with the new funks and even with the older people, it's all samey. And even Uzi Vert, he says, when I made I Just Wanna Rock, which is like his most popular song, this is not a direct quote, but he pretty much said, yo, I made like the worst thing I possibly could. Like, I went in there and said anything. It was like some of the worst stuff I ever made, but then people just loved it. So that also speaks to the audience. But do I believe if Uzi Vert sat down and tried really hard to create a great album, could he do it? No, I don't think he could do it. I think his music, I think the way he raps, it lends itself to freestyling. So he's going to be freestyling. I don't think he has it in him to drop like a great album that's going to stop you in your tracks. You know what I mean? Like Dark Fantasy, like Pilot Talk by Currency. Like, you know, Kanye West has a bunch of them. Uzi Vert does not have that. I don't think he's talented in that way. He's just going to really release good music that young people like. That's of the times, music of the times, not timeless music. So that's what I'll say about, you know, music right now. And even, you know, I usually have an end of year list. Like, I'll compile a list of great albums that I hear throughout the year. I don't feel compelled to do that this year. Like, this year is, even with the artists who have been in the game, even one of my favorite artists, Kendrick Lamar, he dropped last year, but it was less than a year ago to this date. Kind of an album for me. It was kind of mid, you know what I mean? I gave that album 3 stars out of 5. I didn't think it was horrible, but it's not something I'm going to listen to. It's not something I have re-listened to. You know what I mean? And, you know, people, when you look at their top 5 albums of the year, you'll see JPEG Mafia, Danny Brown, Scaring the Hoes album. You'll see Billy Woods, Kenny Siegel, Maps. Shout out to Billy Woods, shout out to Kenny Siegel. But, you know, if JPEG Mafia is like your number 1, number 2 album of the year, and all due respect to JPEG Mafia, but that, if that's like he dropped like the best album of the year to you, that lets you know it was a slow year. Because again, he's not dropping music. JPEG Mafia is not dropping. And again, I'm not having just smoke for the new guys. I'm giving smoke to the underground guys too. So here, JPEG Mafia is not a guy that should ever have like the best album, because his music is more innovative and trying new things than anything. It's disruptive. It's distortive. That's the type of music often that he makes, not all the time. So to him, for them to have the most polished or quality album in a year, it wouldn't make sense for that to happen. That would mean that the rest of the year was slow. So yeah, anyways, very slow year. Where are the new artists at number 1? Where are the great albums at number 2? I think the last great album that I heard that really, you know, I listened to twice because it was so good, was Before Shit Got Weird by the Cool Kids. And I was like, that might have been 2021, maybe 2022. That was the last album I listened to where I'm like, yo, let me play this a couple times, let me hear this in sequence. It's a well sequenced album, good songs. And that was like the last great album that I heard. So anyways, what do y'all think? Am I tripping? Post some new artists who you think are fire. You know what I mean? When Kendrick Lamar came out, it was fire. It was new. It was refreshing. He was doing something different. Same with Cole when he came. Same with Kanye when he came out. Like, even Uzi Vert, even though I gave him some smoke in this video, even when he came out, it was refreshing. Like, Destroy Lonely, this is all derivative. It's like and AI is making their music. The AI is just taking all the popular music and then just combining it, and then that's their music, because it all sounds derivative of something else. They have like AI music, Yeet, Destroy Lonely. It all sounds like something else, and AI could make it. All they have to do is take the popular songs and combine them all together and then push it out, and then that would be their music, respectfully. But anyway, be sure to subscribe if you have not already. This is top5rapwebsite.com.